The following program is designed to demonstrate simple workouts that you can use to improve your health. Be sure to consult your physician before beginning any exercise program.
Hip problems affect many people in our society today, but there is good news. There is an exercise program you can do that will help you. Stay tuned to find out more next on Body and Spirit Aerobics. I'm Dick Nunez, Wellness Director of the Black Hills Health and Education Center. Welcome to Body and Spirit Aerobics. Well, today I'm not jogging out here. I'm actually sitting in a chair next to a fellow named Larry, who works here at 3ABN and has been for a while as a cameraman. And he told me once upon a time he would never do Body and Spirit, but now here he is. And Larry, unfortunately, or fortunately, depending on how you look at it, does have some hip problems. So he's a good one to use for this program today. And I've seen a lot of people suffer with a lot of ailments, and they're amazed at how much better they can get through some simple exercises. So Larry, hopefully that's going to happen for you today as well. We're going to start by doing a little bit of upper body warm up. And so we're going to start by just circling our arms, and we'll try not to hit each other, though we're sitting in their chairs here. I think we got enough room. So we're just coming up and around. We're gonna do a little bit of everything today. We're gonna do a little bit of upper body work, and then we'll get into some work for the hips and try and do a little bit of cardio work too from sitting in the chair. And it does amaze people oftentimes how much you can do while sitting in a chair and still getting an aerobic workout. All right, Larry, let's go the other way now. Many seniors have told me that they'd given up hope, and then they saw that you could do exercise in a chair, and they go, wow, I think I can do that much. And so they do, and all of a sudden they find a whole new life again because they've now started exercising. And let's go and do a couple more. Okay, Larry, now we're gonna lean back in our chair a little bit, scoot your hips forward, okay? And you're gonna take your hands like this, and you're gonna push up and come back down. Push up and down. So we're just doing a press type motion. Press up and down. Press up and down. Imagine you're pushing that big weight up there, Larry. And way up and down. Push up and down. Push up and down. Push up and down. You'll find even though we're not using any weights, that if we do this long enough, you start to feel it.
Yep.
And push and down and push and down and push and down. Press up and down. Press up and down. Push and down and press and down. Let's go 10 more. One, two. Push up, down, up. There's four. And five, and six, seven, three more, eight, nine, and 10. Good. All right, go and sit back up in your chair. You're gonna put your hands behind your head, Larry, and just lean back and let it stretch. That feels good, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. Popping a little bit.
Popping?
Yeah.
Okay. Now give yourself a hug. Pull your shoulder blades apart as you give yourself the hug. Stretching is an important part of exercise. Exercise is made up, or fitness is made up of strength, cardiovascular conditioning, and flexibility. Okay, let's put the hands behind the head again and lay back. Let the elbows fall back as it stretches your chest area. Don't go to sleep on me, Larry. Okay? You'd never hear the end of that, would you?
No.
Okay. And stretch. All right, good. All right, Larry, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna reach out this way and pull back. Reach out and pull. reach out and pull, and reach and pull, and reach and pull back, and reach and pull, and reach and pull, and reach, pull. Reach out, pull back. Reach out, pull back. Reach out, pull back. And reach, pull back. And reach and pull. 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 Five more times. Here's one and two and pull and pull and pull. Good. All right, let's put your right arm up, Larry. Bend at the elbow. Reach up, grab with the other hand and pull. Hold the stretch. We're going to hold it for about 10 seconds. And relax. Okay, now let's put the left arm up. Let it bend, reach up with the right hand, get a hold of it, and pull it over. Okay, and go ahead and relax. How many years you've been working cameras here, Larry?
Well, several years.
Several, okay. All right, now from sitting from the side here, we're gonna raise our arms up out the side and back down. And up and down. And up and down. And up and down. Okay, keep it going. I won't ask you to name names, but have you ever seen anybody start to doze off on the set?
Once in a while.
Once in a while. Just recently, I did a 2-hour live, and I was watching the replay of it. And while reaching, of course, I was involved with the interview, and I started to doze off just a little bit as going on. And all of a sudden, Shelley, who was doing the interview, went, "Dick." And I snapped awake, thinking, oh no, I fell asleep on the set. And up, and down, and up, and down, and up, and down, and up, and down. Now we're gonna bring our hands to here, Larry. We're gonna push up again. And push, and down, and push, and down, and press up, come down, press up and down and up and down and up and down and up and down and up and down. Two more. Up and down and up and down. Okay, now we're gonna bring the palms down like this. Okay, curl up and down and up and down. Curl up, down and curl and down and curl and down and curl and down. Curl up, reach down, curl up and down. Five more times. Down and up and down and up and down. Up, one more time. Okay, now we're gonna take your right arm, put it straight out. Now reach it across to your left. Put your hand behind your elbow and pull. So does it feel different being out here then?
Quite different.
Quite different?
I think I like the other side of the camera better.
You like the other side better? Okay, now let's put your left arm out straight, point it over to your right side, up behind, and pull it over. Well, we appreciate you coming out and doing the show. Okay, and relax. Well, let's start doing a little work on the hips now. I've actually known people, Larry, who were in line for hip replacement surgery, and after going through the workouts, they found that they no longer need the surgery. That happened one time to a woman who came from Detroit, Michigan, who went through the workout or went through the wellness program because she was in line for hip replacement surgery. And then when she got back home, the doctor said, "What have you been doing?" She said, "Well, I went to that wellness program you suggest I go to prepare me for surgery." And he goes, "You don't need the surgery now." So I've seen people avoid that by getting themselves fit and healthy again. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna put our hands on the outside of our knees and we're just gonna push our knees out and bring it back together. Out and together and out and together and out together and out together. By doing this, we're working on our abductors, which are the muscles in our hips that push out and push and push and push. We're giving ourselves resistance with our hands as we push out, and push. Does that feel okay on your hip, Larry?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Okay, as we're going through the workout, you let me know if something's hurting you, because chances are, if it's hurting you, it might be hurting somebody else, so.
It hurts most of the time anyway, so.
It hurts, okay. So it's not making it hurt anymore then, okay?
No, it actually feels better when I exercise.
Good. Okay, and let's go five more. And two, three, four, five. Okay, now put your hands on the inside. Okay, now you're gonna squeeze in and go back out. And squeeze, squeeze in, and squeeze. And squeeze, squeeze in, and squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. We're feeling on the inside of the thighs this time, which is just the opposite. All muscles have an antagonistic muscle area. So for the abduction, which we just did, now we want to work the adduction. All right, we're going to do five more. And two, and three, and four, and five. Okay, Larry, now we're gently just gonna start stepping in place here. Since we're in the chair, we can't really move a whole lot, but we'll do this. Okay, now what we're gonna do, Larry, is we're gonna swing our arms while we're doing this. So let's pick the left foot up, the right arm is up, okay? And we're gonna switch, just like that. Very good. Doing all right there?
Yep, fine.
Okay, good. If you get off step, then all you have to do is stop for a moment, pick one foot up, and then bring the opposite arm up. It's not hard to do. We're doing okay, Larry.
Okay.
Okay, let's try and pick it up just a little bit more. It's a little bit more difficult sitting in the chair, actually, because you can't lift your leg up as high. Okay, we're gonna go for about 20 more seconds, and then we'll switch our motion. Now we're down to 10, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, now Larry, what we're going to do is we're going to bring our leg up and cross it. And that's a tough one for you.
On that hip it is.
Okay, put it down. Now go the other way. Okay, and down, and up, and down, and up, and down, and up, and down. And up, and down, and up, and down, and up, and down, and up, and down, and up. Is loosening up a little bit?
A little.
Okay. So something we all do kind of naturally is cross the legs.
I don't cross legs much. Hard on the hip.
Is it making it hurt more as you do it?
No.
Okay.
It's just I can't pull that left leg up.
That's all right. Just do the best you can. Okay, we're looking good. We won't do this too much longer. That's why you're such a good candidate for the show, Larry, because it starts to hurt you, and we know to back off. Okay, we're going to go for 30 more seconds. For those at home, if you need to stop for a moment and rest, that's okay. Anytime you're going through these workouts, you want to take it at your own pace. Okay, and good. Let's go back into stepping in place. The key to aerobic exercise is rhythmic activity of a major muscle group. So in this case, we're doing our legs. And even though we're just sitting here, you start to feel it after a bit, don't you?
Oh yeah. Getting a little warm.
Getting a little warm? It's just the lights.
Okay.
You don't realize what we go through over here. Now, hip problems can be caused from a wide range of areas, so certainly arthritic hips are very common. And the thing with arthritis is the stronger the muscles are, the less stress your joint's going to have to take. So as we continue developing this, or developing the muscles of the hip area, you'll find that your hip will hurt less. But again, if you overdo it, you'll find yourself hurting more. What I always encourage people to do when they get into exercise, especially if they have bad areas like that, is after they work out, is to go do some icing. Icing down the area will help to discourage any inflammation. Okay, Larry, pick the left leg up, right arm up. Okay, now let's go ahead and bring the arms back into it again. You're doing well.
Hip's getting a little tired.
It's getting tired? Okay.
But it's good.
Well, we're going to go for 20 more seconds this way, and then we'll do something different.
Okay.
And I'm glad you told me. That's important. Okay, let's go ahead and relax. Okay, Larry, let's go back to do this motion now. Out and in. So help stretch it out a little bit. How's that feel? Feel all right?
Yep.
Okay, we're going to do the adduction first this time to let the abductors rest. And even though we're not doing anything quite as strenuous as we were just a moment ago, this is still working the leg muscles and still keeping the cardiovascular benefit going. And of course, for a lot of people, even this will be difficult.
This part's easier.
Yeah, well, for you. But for a lot of people, just walking becomes a chore.
Well, sometimes it's that way for me.
Okay, now let's go to the outside again and push out. And out. How's that feeling?
It's okay.
Okay. We'll do this for a little bit, and then we'll try another movement still and see how that does for you. The pain in your hip is decreasing?
Yes.
Okay.
The warmer the muscle gets, the less the pain.
Okay. Is that your knee I hear, or your hip I hear, or is that the shoes?
That's the chair.
The chair, okay.
I'm
hearing a little bit
yet.
Of a squeaking noise.
I'm not that bad yet.
Okay. Some of your fellow camera people are smiling on that one. Okay, 10 more seconds. Okay, and go ahead and rest. Okay, now we're going to take the left leg and we're just going to step out and bring it back in. Now we're going to go right leg and back in. Left leg, right leg, left, right, left, right. How's that, Larry?
That actually feels good, stretching okay. part.
What you were feeling a little bit ago, was it just a tiredness in the hip, or were you feeling more pain?
It's a little bit of both, I guess. It's a straining on it, I guess.
Okay.
It needs stretching.
Okay. We'll do that in a minute.
Uh-oh.
No, it'll be a good thing.
Okay.
I won't be stretching you, you'll be stretching you. Okay, that's still feeling all right?
Yes, feels okay. better.
A lot of times people simply try and treat their aches and pains by taking a lot of pills, but unfortunately that will mask what's going wrong and they'll just keep irritating it.
That's why I don't take medication.
Instead, we want to see what we can do to correct it naturally as much as possible. Certainly there are those times when a surgical procedure is the only option left, but we want to do everything we can to prevent that. At least most people I know want to do that. Prevent it, that is.
Right.
Okay, we're going to go for 20 more seconds here, Larry. That's still feeling all right?
Yes, it feels good. Stretching, okay. Stretching feels real good on it.
Okay, good. Now what I want you to do, Larry, is get a hold of your left leg and pull it up towards your chest. That feel all right?
Yeah, that feels real good. Stretch it like that.
Okay, now I want you to try and pull it over towards your right leg. So you're shifting your emphasis to your left hand and pushing it over. Okay, that feel all right?
Yeah, it's a little tight, but okay. It feels good.
Okay, now back up towards your chest again. And now bring it across again. Good. Feel a little easier that time?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's loosening up.
Okay, now let's go ahead and get your other leg. Even though it's your left hip that's bothering you, it's important to do both sides.
Balance.
Okay, now move your right leg towards it. As you're pulling over, you should feel it stretching down into the hip area and in the gluteus maximus. Okay, and back up towards your chest. Okay, and back over to the middle again. Okay, good. Now, Larry, this next one might be tough, but I want you to go ahead and try and bring your leg back up here again. Okay? And very gently, you're gonna push on the inside. Now, this one will be a little harder.
Yeah.
Okay, not too much. Okay, good. Switch sides.
That one I have no problem with.
But even still, you can feel it in your hip, can't you?
Yeah, I feel it.
Yeah.
I feel it right in here.
Uh-huh. Okay, good. Now, Larry, what we're going to do is we're going to fold our hands right over our abdomen. We're going to blow out and crunch forward. Then we're going to lean back. Blow out. Crunch forward. Blow out, crunch forward. And back, 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 blow out. And back, blow out. And back, blow out. And back, blow out. And back. Blow out, and back, blow out, and back, blow out, and back. You try and contract your abdomen each time to come forward. Blow out, and blow out, blow out. We'll do five more. There's two. And blow. Three. Blow out. Four. One more time. Blow out. Five. Okay. Now we're going to turn, Larry. We're going to kind of use the chair to help us turn. Stretch the sides. All right, let's go the other way. How's that one feel? That feel all right?
Yep, feels good.
Okay, now we're gonna look straight ahead. We're gonna look up and look down and up and down and up and down. Look up, look down. And up, and down, five more times. Up, and down, and up, and down, and up, and down, and up, and down, and up, and down. Okay, let's look to the side, and look the other way. Back to the left, back to the right. Back to the left, back to the right, back to the left, back to the right, two more each way, back to the left, back to the right, back to the left, back to the right. Okay, Larry, I think that's good. Just go ahead and keep sitting there and we'll go ahead and close the show. At our program at the Black Hills, we have a orthopedic surgeon named Dr. Foster who says on a regular basis, if you have a sore joint and you want to get another 50,000 miles on that joint, get into regular exercise. So if you want to get another 100,000 on that joint, change your entire lifestyle. So you're eating healthy, drinking lots of water, doing all the things you can. And most of all, he encourages people to do it for the glory of God. Because when we're looking to serve God to our fullest, the blessings will be even greater than if we're doing it for self. On this show, on Body and Spirit and Body and Spirit Aerobics, we use the scripture of Philippians 4:13, which states, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. Thank you for joining us. I hope something we did will be of help to you. And we look forward to seeing you next time again on Body and Spirit Aerobics. God bless. We'll see you next time.